keep the secrets of different bills. Hey, don't put them in, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Move from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catch winners with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt. They try to bring me down, see me winning, you ain't like me.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is your man, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you, right? Now listen, as usual, as you know, before we get into this video, make sure you drop a like, right? I need a massive like for this video. Let's get this video to 1,500 likes. Obviously, liking the video pushes it to the recommended, so let's go ahead and get this video to the recommended. As I am dropping an extremely rare build that I know a lot of people have not seen. I'm pretty sure most people have not seen, okay? So make sure you get this video to 1,500 likes and get this build out and on YouTube and into the community, all right? Also, 60K soon in June. And I will be honest with you, my nephews and nieces, we are now creeping to under 1,400 nephews and nieces away to hitting the 60K. So at the rate that we're going, we should hit in 4 days. So we have been slowing down a little bit as far as the subscribers. So let's continue to ramp it up. If you're watching the video, please go ahead and show some love to your favorite uncle, to your favorite old head, Uncle Demi, by becoming an official nephew or niece, okay? Now, let's talk about the slashing playmaker at the pure red pie chart. That is something that I know none of y'all have seen. I know y'all have not seen this. You're going with the pure red pie chart. We're gonna go with the well balanced, because since you are all red and you're already extremely athletic, you will get 99 speed, 99 acceleration, and 99 vert regardless of what you pick. So let's get that strength. As we know, strength has a lot to do with contact dunks. It also has a lot to do with just clamps. When it calls and people pick the ball up, it helps with blow bys. There's a lot of benefits to being strong. So again, as time went on, I had no longer like lowering my weight. I like to keep my weight up. I mean, neutral, or I like to put my weight up, right? What we're gonna do here is we're gonna max out the top three, and then we're gonna drop this down until we get it to 11, right? So that's gonna be 81. Then we're gonna max out all this. That'll get us three shooting. Then we're also gonna max out our pass accuracy and ball handle, all right? And then we're gonna go ahead and go 49, which will get us right at 11 on our post moves. Then our perimeter defense, we wanna go 80, and then 79 on our lateral quickness. Come on, there we go. 78 on our steals. We wanna max out our block. We can actually max out our defensive rebound and then use our remaining four on the offensive rebound to give us 21. So 11, 3, 11, and 21. Obviously, this is a pure red pie chart. So again, we're only left with three shooting badges. So that is something, obviously, that, hey, this is a rare build. That is one of the shortcomings of this, unless, of course, you are a legend. And if you're a legend, then GG, have fun with this, because again, this can be a slashing playmaker that is a straight up demon lockdown that, of course, you know, people are not going to expect. They're not going to expect to see Hall of Fame defense on a slashing playmaker. That's just not going to happen. The typical slashing playmaker that you see is the one made out of the pure playmaking pie chart. That is a typical slashing playmaker. And then the next one would be the one out of the playmaking and slashing pie chart. Those are the two typical slashing playmakers that you see. I dropped the blue and green slashing playmaker, and now I'm dropping the straight red slashing playmaker. So again, you're getting to see different versions of the slashing play. Hopefully you're enjoying this. Of course, on the attributes here, we do have to manipulate them a lot, because obviously if you change them, you will get a different name, and we're trying to prevent that, all right? We do not wanna have that name. So this is what it takes to have that. So instead of having 30 defensive badges, you only have 21. But at the same time, as you progress, this will be something that's really, really toxic, right? Because your body, okay, and also your body type, it can be anything, because we're not changing the weight. So, you know, if you wanna look solid or defined, just go solid, who cares, right? You wanna go 6'1 with this build, you do have to go 6'1. Keep your weight at 182 and your wingspan at 77.4, right? So now look, your speed, acceleration, and vert, like I said, will be 99, right? Your strength will be in a whopping 82 strength. right? 82 strength on a guard, okay? Now, when it comes to your attributes, you do get 5 at 99.9, and you also get 4 at 99. So it just depends on what you, if you're capable of maintaining 99.9. I know some of y'all aren't, so then just look at it as a plus 4. So the ones that are, look at it as a plus 5. I like to count them as plus 5. So your driving dunk will be a 95. Your 3-point shot's a 56, which is good enough because all you need on this game is a 50, as we've proven over and over again. And believe it or not, your mid-range is a 72, which is really good because that means all you really need to do is just get in the mid-range and just start sparking there if they start to play off on you, because obviously they're scared of the blow-by and the contact dunks. Your ball handling will be an 86. Your pass accuracy is an 85. And look at your perimeter. As usual, as my phone is still on, because that's what I do, I always forget to do that. All right, so your perimeter defense is an 85, and your lateral quickness is an 85. And then your steal is an 84. And then, of course, your defensive rebound will be an 83. Okay, so as you look at this all in all, these type of attributes you have never seen on a slashing playmaker defensively, because obviously, you know, you're going with the pure yellow, or you're going with the blue and yellow, so you're not getting these high perimeter defense. An 85 perimeter defense, 85 lateral quickness, 84 steal is ridiculous for a perimeter defense. I mean, for a slashing playmaker. So that is something to get excited about, especially for the ones that, hey, that just want to try something different and have a build that people are like, bro, like, what? How do you have this build as a pure red pie chart? So just keep that in mind. I know some of y'all in the comment sections are just like completely lost. And like, I'm telling you, man, sometimes I feel like the IQ in this community has to be on a whole different level from other communities. People will literally come into the comment section and be like, yeah, man, you know what would be better if you max out the perimeter defense, a lot of quickness and steal. Come on, bro. Obviously. But if you max out the perimeter defense, a lot of quickness and steal, you change the name. The whole purpose of this series is not, and I say that in the description. I say in the description every time. The whole purpose of the Rare Barrel series, or any series I do outside of the meta, is not to maximize the attributes and badges. It's to get unique names and builds, okay? So I don't know why I had to preach this so late in June, but some of y'all are completely lost when it comes to like, what are the purpose of these videos? Y'all will literally be like, yo, man, this build is trash, bro. Why won't you just max out? I'm like, bro, because it changes the name. If you don't like the series, don't watch the series. Like, that's just pretty simple, right? But it looks really bad when you're in the comment section saying like, yo, you know it'd be better if you max this out. And I'm like, bro, like, obviously, genius. Like, obviously, just read the description if you're new to the chat, if you're new, right? But anyway, I digress. All right, so here you have some choices, and I'll be honest with you, all of them you can really do well with. We do know slashing is very OP. The shot creating will help you get a plus 10 to your mid-range, so you have an 80-something mid-range, and it'll give you a 60-something three-point shot, so that might be something you consider. You also can get the lockdown, which will give you a plus 10, so then that 85 perimeter defense now becomes a 95. The 85 lateral quickness now becomes a 95, so that's good. Of course, the playmaking is really good. You'll get that 86. That 86 will go to a 96, so you'll be able to speed boost. Me, personally, I really think it'll come down to the slashing and shot creating, but since the shooting is so watered down, especially for the three-pointer, I will actually go shot creator on this one, right? Because it'll just really help out this build all in all. But there you have it. This is a slashing playmaker right out of the pure red pie chart. So now let's go ahead and test this build. Let's give him the 99, talk about the badges a little bit, and of course, let's get y'all out of here, right? So first, 99. Let's get it. All right, here we go. So give him 99. The typical badges you want to go with is Contact Finisher and Giant Slayer with a build like this. These two are going to be extremely important. The next one I will say go with is Slithery Finisher. Put that on gold. That's just going to help you about as far as avoiding contact. Everything here is just really going to help you as far as getting to the basket and being able to make those difficult shots. And then I will go with Consistent Finisher. Being short, this is something that's really going to help you out. Acrobat will be next, and then Relentless Finisher will be the one I'll say after that. So for the legends, Consistent Finisher, Acrobat, and Relentless Finisher is something you want to look into, right? Here, guys, you do need to go to Quick Draw, because that's just going to help you out with the mid-range shots, and then go with Hot Zone Hunter. But again, like I said, for the legends, you can max out Hot Zone, Range Extender, and be really good from there, and then get Volume Shooter and some Green Machine. But for the ones I just hear that just want to have a build to have fun to play with, Silver Quick Draw with Base 38 is the wave. If you have not seen my jump shot video, you should take a look at that, because obviously I went in depth with that. And then last but not least, you want to go handles for days, quick first step. These two are going to be extremely important, right? You want to get your bell out on bronze. Then of course, ankle breaker and space creator are very important. These are help because this can be an ISO build if y'all didn't realize that. But unfortunately, we can only get one right now because you do want to get your unpluckable at least on bronze and then go here. But I would probably go space creator. Space creator is very OP right now. So I'll probably go space creator, especially when you have shot creating takeover with the go space creator and I'm doing those hop jump steps. That did not make any sense. When you're doing those hop jumps, is it hop jumps? Yo, anyway, man, it's just too early in the morning. So anyway, we're just going to the next one, right? So then we're gonna go clamps on gold. We're going intimidator. You wanna go pick dodger. You wanna go tireless defender. Then from here, let's go interceptor. You do have block, so maybe you can go chase down, which is gonna be pretty funny. Rim protector, and then we can go pickpocket too. So we can go pickpocket. We can do that. That's not bad at all. And then of course, if you are a legend, I'll say max out your pickpocket and then max out. So that'd be six. So that'd be four. Off ball pass Hall of Fame. Max out just the Hall of Fame. So that will leave you with four left. And then maybe go here, here, and here. That'll leave you one more left. And then maybe you can go interceptor on gold then or something like that. I mean, it's whatever your preference is, but keep in mind, pogo stick would be good, but just 6-1, you wouldn't need that. You do have a high rebound. That's why I say go ahead and get your rebound. Off ball pass is really good. It helps with not getting your ankles broken, as you can see at the top. And it says hold the matchup and don't get their ankles broken as often. And I've been messing around with that, and I feel like it is true. Like, it does help out. So that's something that I can definitely put my stamp of approval on, as far as, you know, that is something to consider also, right? All right, but anyway, my nephews and nieces, hopefully enjoyed this video. If you did, you know exactly what you need to do. Drop a like, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Of course, tune in to me on Twitch every single evening as I try to stream just as well as much as I drop a video every single morning at 9. I try to stream sometime in the early evening, so take a look at that. But other than that, this is your man, Uncle Demi, and I'll be back really, really soon, another banger. You know, when I say I'll be back soon, another banger, you know exactly what day I'm talking about, man. I'm talking about tomorrow. I'm out.